Welcome to this video on setting the loci for microsatellite analysis with Geneious Prime. After fitting the ladders, the next step in the microsatellite analysis workflow is to set the loci. To do this, select all the sequence traces and choose the locus info button. In the locus information window, you can adjust the die settings individually. These include defining the number of peaks, repeat units and range for each loci. Adjust these settings based on the known characteristics of your loci of interest. To add or remove additional loci, use the plus and minus buttons. For this example, the expected number of peaks is 2, and the repeat unit is 4. For the 6 fam die, the range is 160 to 450. Ensure you adjust the settings for all dies you are using. Once finished, click OK. Then click Save to save the loci as a new file. Ensure you give the loci a suitable name. With the loci set, go through your data, one trace at a time, and look for any known data artifacts such as plus A stutter or slippage peaks and pull-ups. You will need to correct any incorrect peaks before you can perform binning. For example, stutter peaks are minor peaks 1 to 4 repeat units away from the actual peak. To remove an incorrectly called stutter peak, select it and either press Delete or use Remove Peak. Ensure you also add in any missing peaks that should have been called by selecting a peak and choosing Add Peak. Once done, remember to save your changes. You're now ready to perform the binning. To learn more, visit geneious.com.